Disclosure, I was invited by the Panzermuseum Munster in 2019 and 2020. Recently I noticed that a German combat engineer that served with the Ukrainian Legion in Bakhmut and other locations stated that the German Wiesel could have a significant impact on the battlefield in Ukraine. As such, I asked him, based about his frontline experience, why he thinks that this is the case, and additionally I asked a former Leopard 2 gunner that faced Wiesels as opponents in exercises to get a better idea of its capabilities against main battle tanks as well. First off, some basic information on the Wiesel. We are looking at the Wiesel 1 here. The Wiesel 2 is bigger and used mostly in support roles. The Wiesel 1 has two main variants. One with the 20mm autocannon and one with an anti-tank guided missile. Previously this was the TOW, nowadays it's mostly the MALS spike system. Although it should be no problem to equip the Ukrainian Stugna or similar systems. Some technical data. In terms of length, the hull is about 3.26 meters. If we add the 20mm machine cannon, it has an overall length of 3.55 meters. The height and width is about 1.8 meters. The combat weight is given with 2,687 kg, which is about 5,924 pounds, and a crew of 2 men. Note that the TOW variant has a crew of 3 men and a combat weight of 2,847 kg. The engine is a 5-cylinder turbo diesel with 87 horsepower. This gives the Wiesel 1 a horsepower to magic ton ratio of 32.4. In comparison, the Leopard 2 A6 has about 24.2. The Leopard 1A5 had 19.6 ton, the Panther 13.4 horsepower per ton, and the Panzer 4G had 12. Of course, such a low weight can also have some drawbacks. Here you can see the Wiesel 1 driving around during Stahlhofterheide 2019, and it is quite a bumpy ride. As such, I suspected that Wiesel's toppling over might be a regular issue, but then I asked the Leopard 2 gunner. He noted at least he has not encountered such an incident. Of course, this could be different for specific terrain, for instance, heavy cratered areas. The fuel tank at the back has a capacity of 80 liters, which is about 21 US gallons, and an overall and operational range is noted at 400 kilometers by the MHM Dresden. This is about 250 miles, although another source notes 200 to 300 kilometers. In terms of speed, the maximum speed is noted with 80 km per hour on roads, which is almost 50 miles per hour. For cross country, the speed is around 60 km per hour, which is about 37 miles per hour. Yet more interesting is probably the very high cross country mobility of the Wiesel due to its low weight and limited ground pressure. This is also supported by the fuse of the Leopard 2 gunner, he noted.
They are made to do like flanking maneuvers, drive through terrain that is not suited for main battle tanks or other larger vehicles, and they could drive even through dense forest because of their dimensions, both in size and weight. They could drive to any terrain that is not suited for even trucks.
For a deeper look into the Wiesel, be sure to check out my video on it. So what about the main points that the German combat engineer mentions? He notes that his experience with the Wiesel is based on exercises in Germany. Additionally, he talked with Wiesel 2 commanders and people that faced them in exercises as well. One point is that these vehicles were able to outmaneuver the enemies and engage from the flanks or even behind. Additionally, their cross-country mobility and small size allowed them to disengage extremely quickly as well. If they were well coordinated, this allowed them to create chaos from several directions in enemy columns. This is also in line with the Leopard 2 gunner's experience.
A good controlled Wiesel is mostly not possible to detect. Either you're looking there just by pure coincidence, that you're looking into a forest and maybe then you see something moving there. But normally, if they are already on your flanks, it's too late and then you won't spot them. Most of the time, they know exactly where you are, but on the other hand, it's quite hard to detect them. When you are doing, for example, in German we call it Beobachtungshalt, where you stop, turn off the engine, and you also listen, if you can listen for engines and stuff like this. MBT, you can clearly recognize MBT engine over several kilometers. And that's why normally in forests MBTs are driving with low RPM to be more silent. But Wiesel can get very close to you, even if you don't hear it. It's compared to more to like a Fennec, if you know it, on the level of the Silent, it's possible. And that's the danger, that you can't really spot it on combat distances by sound, and through its movement, that it's that small, it can stay behind even smaller hills. If you see the size, it's comparable to like a Volkswagen Golf, or even smaller, I think, compared to the new ones. And it can just use anything as cover, small hills, even a shed or smaller buildings. Everything can be used as cover for these systems. And normally you only see the weapon popping out, either the toe or MELS now, the Spike anti-ATGM, or the autocannon.
The Weasel is small, very small. The hull without the gun has a length of mere 3.26 meters and a width of 1.8 meters. In contrast, the T-72 has a length of 6.95 meters without the gun and a width of 3.59 meters. So the Weasel has about half the length and width, but since we have to multiply those values, the Weasel is less than a quarter of a T-72, which is still smaller than a Leopard 2, as you can see here. So why is this important? Well, for several reasons. First, it is a smaller target. This means it's harder to detect and to hit. Second, it can also move into areas where other vehicles can't move or would create much more noise or other detectable signals. Third, it is also easier to camouflage. A regular camonette of decent weight is sufficient. You need far less leaves, grass and other materials as well than with a full-blown tank. Now these are general points, but they are points that are specific to the battlefield in Ukraine, as the combat engineer points out. He notes that tank versus tank combat is rare, very rare. Now many of you probably know the area is rather flat and very large. As such, this would seem ideal for long-range engagements with direct fire weapons. But he notes that there is a catch to this. The fields in Ukraine are often intersected by small woodlines that protect against erosion. Yet these lines mean that the ranges for direct fire are usually far lower than one would expect. Another aspect of the fields in Ukraine is that during summer, the plants in them are rather large, like corn and sunflowers, which also interferes with ground observation significantly. As previously noted in an interview with him about the T-55, both Ukrainians and Russians use a lot of weapons in indirect fire, like tank guns. Now, one major weakness of the Weasel is the rather weak armor protection, yet main battle tanks also have rather weak armor on top. So an artillery hit on top with a 152mm shell on a Leopard 2 would be deadly as well, according to both the combat engineer and the Leopard 2 gunner. The Weasel is likely more affected by near misses, but at the same time it is far smaller as well. Additionally, spotting is often done by drones, so from above. The woodlands are generally too small to hide a main battle tank or an infantry fighting vehicle properly, yet for a Weasel this would be less of an issue. Furthermore, the Weasel could easily move into such tree lines without hitting any trees or creating large drag marks like a tank. The Leopard 2 gunner noted,
with the Leopard you are still bound to either open fields or pathways and places where you can drive with your weight that you don't sink in, and where you can physically fit into it without like hitting stuff with the vehicle itself that will slow you down, especially with the cannon hitting trees. While the Weasel can drive through many forests directly, because the distance between trees is often bigger than the width of the vehicle itself. And it gives this Weasel basically the possibility to drive everywhere it wants, and that with a decent amount of speed. While the Leopard has their to be a bit slower, even if he has all his engine power and his high top speed in open field. But this Weasel is, let's say, off-road capabilities and off-map capabilities that you can expect it from terrains the way you don't expect it, is better than the Leopard.
The combat engineer also notes that although Russian optics are generally behind Western standards, that they have a different approach, namely to employ a lot of radar reconnaissance. This means also ground surveillance radar. How is this related to the Weasel? Well, first off, the Weasel signature is again smaller, and second, the signature is very likely unknown to the Russians, or even if it is not, their experience and thus fine-tuning with it is certainly limited. The Weasel probably appears more like a small car on the radar than a BMP or a Leopard. This would also mean, even if it is identified correctly, it likely would not rise to the top of the Russians' priority list anyway. Speaking of priorities, if you like well-researched books based on sources from the German and Russian military archives, check out the books from our publishing house, the Military History Group. Links are in the description. Next, a minor or major point, depending on who you ask, is the Wiesel's maintainability. Like the Leopard 2, it has a power pack.
Next to the driver, under here, is the power pack. So you have your engine, your transmission system, cooling system, everything in here. A good maintenance crew can change this whole system in about 50 minutes.
Yet there's more to it. The engine is a civilian-grade engine. Additionally, the combat engineer noted that he can't recall a single complaint about maintenance problems with the Wiesel. Of course, this is anecdotal evidence, but you also need to keep in mind that the Wiesel weighs less than 3 metric tons. As such, a lot of the troubles that we know from tanks are less of an issue due to its light weight. The next point is firepower. Now, one might argue that the 20mm machine cannon is rather weak compared to the 25mm Bushmaster of the US Bradley or the 30mm guns on the Russian BMP-2. Yet both of these vehicles are significantly larger, so compared to the size and mobility of the Wiesel, this is a huge gun or dickes Gerät. And the Wiesel is not made to face opponents directly, but to outmaneuver the enemy and hit it from the flanks. Be aware, the Wiesel has 2 belts of ammo for the autocannon, high explosive and ammo piercing. This is also in line with the experience the Leopard 2 gunner had on exercises. Here is commands on Wiesel tactics.
Mostly these autocannons and these ATGM versions are working together, because obviously the ATGM is to engage the hard targets like main battle tanks or even APCs. While still this unit needs to defend itself if they get into infantry or get into softer vehicles. And there this 20mm is good enough to deal with infantry and smaller vehicles, and I think even with enough of ISVs like BMP-1 or BMP-2 is in that case. Well, the thing that had most influence on us was obviously ATGM Wiesels, because they could take out us, and they turned into either in defensive roles to be on our flanks where we didn't expect them, like we were pushing and they were just waiting or in cover on the side to take us out from the side. Or when we were defending, that they tried to outflank us both left and right in terrain that was hard to overwatch without optics and our guns from our position. I mean, you have to know that the tank is not standing on a hill exposing itself. It's still trying to get a good position that is giving you both cover, but also a good perspective to the enemy. And these vehicles will just outflank you or try to outflank you and use their strengths against you.
Wiesel variant with the anti-tank guided missile. This variant would be able to kill anything on the battlefield, currently assuming a modern ATGM is used. The combat engineer noted that currently there are teams that use Toyota Hilux pickup trucks equipped with Concours or similar anti-tank guided missile systems that shoot and scoot. In contrast, the Wiesel would be smaller, better protected and more mobile than a Hilux. Due to the use of tracks, the ground pressure of the Wiesel is also lower. Speaking of ground pressure, one point there where we are not really sure is how it would deal with the deep mud. It could be a problem. It is hard to tell if the low ground pressure of the Wiesel is good enough here. Yet even if this is not the case due to its rather lightweight, recovering the Wiesel should also not be a big deal. Finally, the combat engineer noted an example in regard to urban combat and how vehicles are used in these situations. He notes that, for instance, the BMP-2s are used for a specific fire mission in urban combat. This means that one drove to a designated area, fired a complete magazine of 30mm into a building, window or similar target, then immediately moved out of the position again. So a lot of shoot and scoot, since both sides are equipped with a lot of anti-tank weapons that dispose of BMPs rather easily. Here the Wiesel would be a great asset, since it can do the same thing, is a smaller target and can also take paths that are not possible for a BMP. Additionally, it can be parked in a small garage, like a Lada. To conclude, the Wiesel very likely could be used to great effect in Ukraine. Its mobility, small profile and significant firepower would allow it to surprise the enemy and hit him in the flanks or even rear. The low weight and civilian engine make it easy to recover and maintain. The main weakness of the Weasel is the weak armor protection, but since both sides have plenty of anti-tank weapons, armor protection is a limited asset, whereas the Weasel, with its high mobility, strong camouflage and small target signature, has a lot of additional protection features that are not available to main battle tanks or infantry fighting vehicles. Of course, this assumes that the Weasel is properly employed. It is important to keep in mind that for major breakthrough operations or sustained engagements, the Weasel is clearly less suited. Additionally, the combat engineer's experience is, from my knowledge, mostly based on infantry operations. To get a better understanding of how it is to face a Weasel in a main battle tank, the full interview with the Leopard 2 gunner will be soon released on my second channel and should already be in early access for my Patreon supporters. Thank you to Butya and Tobias for their insights. Thank you to Andrew for refreeing the script. Thank you to the Panzermuseum Munster for inviting me. Thank you for watching and see you next time.